couple quick pointers with regard to your footwork. One, try not to go too far out, right? Remember, if you go wide, you can still eat this, right? Now, if he's coming very vertical, right, then, right, we could still get away. Or if he comes vertical, I could do this, but now I can't do anything. Sorry. All right. So we're looking to get in here more. Remember your 10-30 angle? I say 10 and 2. The actual angle is 10-30-130, right? But depending upon where your foot ends up, that 10 and 2, it's a pretty good guide. Same thing with 8 and 4. It's 430 and 730 is the true angle. We're looking for the true 45, right? Me, for my training, since everyone tended to be bigger, I tend to do more of an 11. That's just my flavor. But anywhere somewhere in here is what you're looking for, okay? I see a lot of people starting to go out to here, okay? That's number one. Number two, as you do this and you do this, I'm seeing this. You see how all my weights, I got 80-85% on my front leg? Remember, this is coming next. You get the two, right? You're stuck on your lead leg. You don't want to be that way, okay? So when you go here, this. See the difference between that and this? So I'm going to push off my back leg as opposed to lean in to my front leg. That sounds like a semantic, but there's a difference. You should try to feel that out, okay? Remember, also, we're training. This is practice distance, okay? This is practice distance so that no one gets popped in the eye or actually pop. Okay, but when we really do this, you need to be more active with this one. This is shielding, yes. We're not just doing this so that when this comes, we get hit there. It's not, yeah, but that's not all that it does. We come here, this can stop or at least slow down the next strike. Okay, then, boom, this hit. And notice I'm going all the way through. You guys remember shoulders and armpits, right? I'm looking, if I'm gonna go over, I put his shoulder in my armpit. We're about the same size, so I can choose either one.